Hi everyone! After I did background for this page, I was quite happy how everything started and I was quite excited to proceed coloring houses. But then everything went so wrong. I already noticed that if I start to color when I am tired or simply when I am working for a long time on the same page, even if I have enough free time and I'm able to spend a couple of hours working on the same page, I gradually start to be tired, and in such case I quite often make a wrong color choice. It's much better for me if I have enough free time to switch between pictures and not to work for a long time on the same page. So it was the case with this page. I started to work on houses and I made a very unwise color choice. On the first step, I decided to color this pavement, and I decided to make it again with brown colors because it's a part of the tree, but I decided to add brighter accents around houses. First, it will indicate that we have a light coming from houses, and also these bright spots will help to attract attention to these cute houses. Also, I used light amber and dark brown Prismacolors, but then I decided that I want to save my precious prismas and that I can use Derwent color softs to color this relatively big area. So I combined color soft cream, pale brown, brown, brown earth, and I was really happy again how they behave on this paper, at least for covering big areas without many layers, just to get nice smooth coverage, to get very quick burnishing, they behaved really well. Next, I needed to color houses, and I don't know what the hell I was thinking, and I selected pink and blue, only slightly darker than colors which I already used for the background. I don't know why I decided that selecting similar colors will look good. Maybe I had an idea that these tree houses have to be a part of the tree. I don't know. I thought that I wanted to use soft pastel colors for almost everything on this page, apart from the lady gnome and maybe dresses in the shopping windows. So that's why I started to color houses with sand, with rose pink and with blue violet colors. And almost immediately I realized that it wasn't a nice choice. Houses looked totally lost on the background. I started to add more contrast colors for the shading, and in the end I added so many colors that I got something very motley and child-looking. Now I think that everything would look much better if I simply colored both houses with burnt ochre or sienna brown and added bright details in the shopping windows. But as I said, while I was coloring, I was a little bit tired, my minds were everywhere, I thought about other things, and I realized quite late that something went quite wrong with my page, and I have to save everything before it's not too late. So if you want to color along with me, I highly recommend not to follow my steps and simply color both houses using some warm brown colors. it will look nice and on the background, and it will also look like a part of this wooden shopping alley, and in the same time it will be easier for you to select brighter colors when you will need to color details and the lady gnome. I still hope that I will be able to save everything because I really love this page, but it will be a good lesson for me. If you are tired or if you are pensive, if you don't feel quite active and creative, it's better for me to switch to other hobbies, like cross-stitching, which is calming and don't need any creativity, just to be attentive and to be calm and to do these mechanical movements. Anyway, I hope to see you in the final part, where I will show you, would I manage to save this page or not?
Thank you. Thank you.